Like all living things, the United States of America has a genetic code, a cycle of life, and a unique destiny. The United States as we know it is actually the product of a conception, a birth, between the Puritans who came here in 1630 and the Native Americans who've been here essentially forever. The mixing of this genetic code gave us a unique DNA double helix that has characteristics of both cultures. For example, and most importantly, the United States Federal Constitution is derived from the Iroquois Confederacy, the Hodenosaunee unification for peace that happened in 1140 AD and which lived more than 600 years and was cited by Ben Franklin as a source of the federal constitution. So when we look at what makes up the United States of America and what has made us up since our birth, we have to take equal consideration for the native cultures and for the Puritan cultures that came here from Europe. This conception resulted in the birth of the United States in 1776. And with this birth, we see the beginnings of six distinct cycles of United States history that form a spiral. The embryonic state of the United States of America actually happened in 1688 with the Glorious Revolution. It spans through six cycles, with each with a burst of energy, a springtime awakening, a summer of war, a fall of reaction, and a wintertime of aftermath, where people are concerned primarily about materialism and don't want to have anything to do with political change. This aftermath period always ends with an economic downturn. And that economic downturn spurs a new burst of energy, which is embodied, as I said, in the 1688 Glorious Revolution, with the coming of Andrew Jackson, with the barely contested election of 1896, followed by the coming of Woodrow Wilson and Theodore Roosevelt, with Franklin Roosevelt, with John F. Kennedy, and finally with Jimmy Carter. These six cycles also have a very distinct characteristic, which is that they are getting shorter. And in fact, the six cycles of our history comprise a spiral. This spiral reached its peak in 1945 when the United States of America achieved full adulthood. We had the world's biggest empire, we had the atomic bomb, we had full employment, and we were loved all over the world. From there, we went into decline. And the decline ends in 1992 with the defeat of George H.W. Bush and the election of Bill Clinton. This victory by Clinton inaugurates the third phase of our treatment of United States history, which is getting to Solartopia. We were born, we lived through six cycles, and in 1992, the mantle of power in America passed from the previous generation, from the Reagan-Bush generation, to Bill Clinton, to George W. Bush, and now to Barack Obama. The first time we've had three re-elected presidents since the early 1800s, and this is the time of globalization and of getting to Solartopia. On this planet, we also have globalization with NAFTA, with GATT, and with the power of the internet, transforming really the ability of human beings to coordinate and to communicate. We also have, actually, in many ways, the triumph of the Cultural Revolution. In every springtime of the cycles of our history, we have had the rise of feminism, of campaigns for minority rights, of campaigns for the environment, and for peace. And with the coming of the baby boom generation, the Cultural Revolution, especially including the campaign for gay rights, has taken control of the mainstream of the culture. What hasn't triumphed is the power of the people to control corporations. And in our major challenge now, at the end of the spiral of our history and the coming of the Solartopian age, is to somehow cure the virus of the corporation. The United States of America and the world as a whole is infected with a disease of corporate power, in which we have institutions that have been given human rights but don't have human responsibilities and are not held accountable. As a result of that, in this new Solartopian era, we confront the destruction of our global ecology, and we have the technology to cure this disease. Technology will never cure human ills, but human beings using technology can save our planet. And that's what we have to do. Certain technologies, such as renewable energy, photovoltaic cells in particular, organic food, and other holistic methods of approaching our life on Earth. This is the challenge of the Solartopian age. This is how we need to cure our corporate disease. And this is the culmination, the unique destiny of the United States of America, which was the conception between Puritans and Indians, which ran its course in the six cycles that comprise the spiral of history, and now leave us with the challenge of the Solartopian age, of getting to a point where the baby boom generation, this global generation, can master the internet, can master renewable and other healthful technologies, and guarantee our survival on Earth at the peak of the spiral of United States history.
Don't you know we're gonna have a Solartopia all alone?